Meet the Diet Parents.
If they wake up tonight, it's your turn.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. I did last night.
But they didn't wake up last night.
That's irrelevant. I was ready to do it. It wasn't needed.
No, it's whoever was last woken up, it's the other person's turn.
Well, no, quite often we both get woken up. It's who's ready to leave the bed. I was ready last night. So I probably had a more shallow night's sleep than I would have done.
Diet Parents.
I'm not sure how old I was, maybe around 7, when I bit someone at school, and I made them bleed. And so my mum decided it was time to go to the dentist. When I got there, I like to think that there were many other children with fangs, or maybe other things with fangs that needed filing. But there weren't any. So I went in, and the dentist set to work filing my fangs off, and my God, did it hurt. I left the dentist with my mum, with no fangs.
Voices on the wind, soft whispers from the sky, sweet voices on the wind, echoing inside. I took up arms for war, arms for my country, took up arms for my France, and raised her up a king. Blood for my country, spilled from the heart of me, shed for my country, to raise up a king. Left by my country, now charged with heresy, a bargain for the enemy. Abandoned by my king, they pile up kindling, flesh will be burning. They lay wood for my death and say they're men of God.
I used to go out with 2 men. Trouble was, I just couldn't cope with so much sex. So I tossed a coin. Heads for the guy with the vasectomy, tails for the guy without the vasectomy. Heads it was. I just couldn't leave it at that. And I tossed again and again and again. On the 15th toss, it came up tails. Oh, the father of my children, completely random.
Oh.
tired parents. Meet the tired, tired parents.
If one of them wakes up tonight, it's definitely your turn.
Why?
Because I did it last night. And the night before. Last night I was in there for 40 minutes, twice, getting Leo back off to sleep.
It wasn't 40 minutes.
It was.
It wasn't.
And you were asleep. Unless you were pretending.
I wasn't pretending. I just woke up when you went out. Quickly looked at the clock. Then I went back to sleep, because I was tired. Then, when you came back in, you were making so much noise, I woke up again. Just saw the clock. Then went back to sleep.
Diet, diet, parents.
Why didn't you say you could hear me then?
It's quite impossible for three people to hear them.
Oh, why don't I do some jacket potatoes?
Some are bigger.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
I'm actually conditionally disabled.
No, I'd just send it over.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that.
You're telling me?
No, hold on, you're telling me.
It's for you. It's for you, though.
I know. I'll come back and I'll see you drinking.
Just say to her, I've heard, done a dusting.
I'm sorry, we have been unable to detect a response.
Goodbye.
A memorial service was held at the Church of the Blessed Virgin, Burham, where C. West had been wed. It was not until 2 or 3 years after the accident that the first ghost sightings were made. Motorists travelling alone and often at night would pick up a woman hitchhiker at the bottom of the hill. She would ask for a lift into Rochester and insist on sitting in the back of the car, but then as they reached Week Street, the drivers would turn around only to find their passenger had disappeared.
Thank you.
The holiday is over. I've unpacked. All I can do is try to remember what happened in the wood. How did it happen? Which way did it happen? What was it? The magic's gone. I'm back.
Diet parents, diet parents, meet the diet, diet parents.
Managed to finish that book this morning.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, that's good. Really good.
That's the second book you've read this month, I'd say.
You know, it's ages that I've read that much.
And you discover that new band you'd never heard of.
That was great, that. It's really nice to have a new band. I've been listening to it loads.
Yeah, I can't remember the last time I discovered a new band or managed to find the time to read a book.
You know, with kids and everything like that, it's important to keep hold of a bit of your own interest.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with you. Just with two kids, it tends to be just one person or the other that manages to do that, doesn't it?
No. I don't know. You went to the cinema last week.
What was that?
You went to watch that film last week.
Frozen.
The Diet Diet Peril.
You hear that sound? There it is again. What's it mean? Why am I hearing it? Is it in my head? You may think I'm making it all up, or that I'm overreacting. My God, that sound frightens me. What if it is in my head? Am I going mad? Going mad?
My friend Bryn has been going to see a shaman. He helped Bryn slip deep into a trance and asked her to look for her spirit guide, which would be in the form of an animal. Bryn saw a black bear. Bryn then asked me if I wanted to try the same thing. So I closed my eyes. And I saw a small black cougar sitting on the picnic table in my garden, and then sitting on the well in front of the house. Whenever I tried to go close, it would bat me away. Bryn said she'd often had a black panther with her on her spiritual journeys, and her shaman said it must be Katie. I love the image of the black bear and the black cougar hanging out together.
I'd bomb the hell out of the oil fields. I'd then get Exxon. I'd then get these great oil companies to go in. They would rebuild them so fast your head will spin. You ever see how fast they put up rigs? These guys are unbelievable. So I'd go ExxonMobil. I'd go to the top five oil companies. They'd be in there. They'd be finished so fast.
You need U.S. troops to protect the oil companies?
Yes. You put a ring around them. You put a ring. You've just taken all of the wealth away. This is what should be done.
My brain is numb, and my hands are freezing cold. It's like they aren't my hands. Go on, help yourself. My brain doesn't feel like my brain either.
Meet the Diet Diet Perils.
It's really nice of John, isn't it, and Louise to let us go out for the night and babysit.
Yeah, it's lovely.
You know, they didn't have to do that. We're staying at their house. It's very nice of them.
It's really nice of them.
A lovely couple.
Yeah, they are. Good kids too.
Yeah, really good. House is lovely, isn't it? It's really nice.
Yeah, really nice.
Really tidy.
Yeah. It is.
I like it. It's just, you know, no clutter anywhere. Quite relaxing, isn't it?
Their kids are a bit older, aren't they? They can afford not to have so much clutter.
I think it's more to do with them. I think they're quite tidy.
Yeah, maybe too tidy, would you say?
No.
It seems a bit too tidy to me, somehow.
How can anything be too tidy?
Well, just, you know, I like bits and pieces and not too museum-like.
I'd say it's museum-like, really. I'd say it's just relaxed, tidy.
Yeah. I prefer our home.
Meet the Diet Diet Perils.
Be good and go to mass like my mother bade me. Be good and love God.
I heard an angel come down to counsel me, but they say no angel. They blame the lady's tree.
Blame it on the lady's tree. Build fires under me. Murder maidens in the flames and say you're men of God.
Flowers will fall now, white petals to the ground, just as these ashes fall from the lady's tree.
Thank you.
smooth.